Let's look at a different workflow for generating videos from first and last frames. Why is it different? You should note that I now have three reference images representing three different key actions. Now let's look at the generated result. Yes, these three key actions are all included in the final generated video. Therefore, this technique is equivalent to extending our traditional first and last frame video generation to keyframe video generation. We will find that the generation quality and the coherence of the character reference are much better. Here, we will use an extension. This extension enhances the Wan22 first and last frame video generation. The installation of the extension is relatively simple. You just need to put it into your custom node folder. Furthermore, it does not require installing any additional dependencies. I have also built all the workflows on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub in the ComfyUI domain. Running Hub is an excellent online working platform. This is because whenever new technology appears, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in the video description, which will grant you 1,000 free points. Additionally, logging into Running Hub daily will grant you 100 points, allowing you to try out your own workflows. Next, we will introduce the basic usage of this extension. The basic structure of this workflow is a standard Wan22 first and last frame video generation workflow. Of course, we need to make some slight modifications. First, we need three images, which serve as the three keyframes of the video. When generating these three images, try to ensure that the basic scene and actions are connected, and the differences should not be too large. For each image, we configure it according to our basic settings. Note that I am currently using 960 by 544, and the number of frames generated is 81 frames. We scale each image to align it with our resolution. Next is our model loading. Please note that we are currently using the standard Wan22 high noise and low noise models. Pay attention to the LoRa. We are using the 1022 version of Light X2V. We will also use the text encoder VA and our visual encoder. My prompt is very simple. I directly wrote best quality dynamic motion. This means I hope it has a relatively high quality and plenty of movement. Now, the most crucial point comes. This key point is actually injecting our reference images into the latent space. To do this, we use a node from this extension. This node is called Wan First Middle Last Frame. This node can handle three keyframes. It actually has another node that can handle four keyframes, which is the one you see now. However, I don't think it is very meaningful because it is still affected by computing power. For example, if you are running 121 frames, it is still a bit difficult to run with our current basic computing power. Therefore, I think the three keyframe option has greater practical value. Its inputs include our positive condition, negative condition, Virginia E, and our three reference images named start image, middle image, and end image, respectively. Additionally, there are three inputs resulting from the visual encoding of the three images. Pay attention, there are three important personalized settings here. First is the position of your middle frame. Generally, we place it exactly in the middle. Of course, you can adjust the left and right positions yourself. If you feel that the action difference between the second keyframe and the first keyframe is small, you can adjust the position to be smaller. If you feel that the difference between the second frame and the third frame is small, you can adjust it to be larger. In general, putting it exactly in the middle is sufficient. These two settings relate to the middle frame. The first is a constraint on high noise sampling specific to the middle frame. That is, how much influence the middle frame has on the high noise sampling stage. Here, it is generally sufficient to set it to around 0.6. Similarly, this is the influence of the middle frame on the low noise model sampling. Generally, it should be less than 0.2. In this way, we can obtain three conditions. You should note that originally we had two conditions, but now we have three conditions. These three conditions consist of two positive conditions and one negative condition. We split the two positive conditions into a positive condition for the high noise model and a positive condition for the low noise model. The negative condition is universal. Similarly, we can also generate a latent. Below is our sampling stage. This is not significantly different from before. Note that the official workflow sets the shift to 11. I am using 8 here. The impact is actually not significant. Furthermore, during the optimization stage, I also enabled CFG 0 star in the high noise model. For the low noise model, I enabled Sage Attention. Then I used the One Video Nag node. I also used 8 steps for sampling. and the sampling algorithms used are Euler and simple. This is the result after decoding. Take a look. There is some flickering or loss of focus here. It is very obvious that it might appear blurry or unclear for a moment. This effect usually occurs when switching keyframes. The method for handling this, as mentioned here, is to reduce the low noise model influence to the minimum, meaning setting it directly to zero. The purpose of this setting is to prevent the middle reference frame from affecting the low noise model sampling. This results in a better overall effect. Now, let's look at the second workflow. The second workflow is simply adjusting that low noise value to zero. Let's look at the final generated effect. We will find that the sudden flickering and loss of focus we saw just now are gone. However, you must note that in this workflow, the three images are still relatively correlated. At the very least, the perspective has not changed, meaning the background is the same. If you now increase this difference, can it still handle it completely? Let's look at the third workflow. For the third workflow, I selected three different reference images. The first image is a beautiful woman walking in front of a concrete wall. The second is her suddenly turning around with a very elegant movement. The third is where I made a relatively large change in perspective. The difference between the second and third images is quite large. In this situation, can it fully present all three actions during the 81 frame sampling process? After all, the differences are significant. Look, the overall effect is also fantastic. We find that all three key actions are present, and the overall transition is also relatively smooth. However, you must note that if we want to use this kind of technology, we recommend using images with relatively small differences as reference frames, because if the difference is too large, the frame count will definitely not be enough. This may lead to unexpected results. Additionally, vertical video performs better than horizontal video. This is because vertical video focuses on the character and the environmental details are relatively less prominent. This makes overall consistency easier to achieve. Horizontal video, besides the main subject, spends a large part of its presentation on the background and lighting. When the keyframes have large differences, it puts pressure on the model's performance. But regardless, this technology is certainly a great complement and enhancement to first and last frame video generation. Well, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.